What up, guys? It's Avery back here with another video of Honest Judgment, and this time I'm going to be doing something special. It is Valentine's Day, and I'm single as shit, but I'm going to take this idea from Drunk History. So I don't know if you've seen Drunk History, but basically what it is, it's a TV show on Comedy Central, and they get celebrities and they get them really drunk, and then they pretty much just retell history. So, like, for example, if they were talking about Billy the Kid, like, as a subject, they would get a celebrity drunk, and then he would be just talking about Billy the Kid and, like, you know, what he did, what he's famous for, is he good, bad, yada yada, you know, just a history lesson on it. And the funny thing is that since people are so drunk, they, you know, mix up dates, they, like, add random stuff that didn't even happen. And the cool thing is that that show, whatever celebrities, you know, talking, they actually do reenactments with lip syncing. So if somebody hiccups or burps or is just like says something that has nothing to do with the story, they get reenactors, which are other celebrities, and you know, so they lip sync that, and it's pretty funny. It's hysterical. And I actually wanted to do this series for October because I wanted to do the same thing where where I get drunk, or me and my friends get drunk, and then we try to, you know, explain horror movies, you know, especially since it's October. That's what I wanted to do it. I wanted to do it last year, but things got so busy. But I feel like, you know, Valentine's Day is a perfect one to start. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be getting drunk, and then I'm going to be, you know, trying to retell the movie The Notebook, because everybody knows about that movie. I've seen that movie a few times, and so everybody knows what the twist is and what everything is, but I'm going to see, I haven't seen it in a while, so I don't remember the main characters, I don't remember events that happened in the actual movie, I just remember, you know, bits and pieces. So hopefully, you know, when I'm drinking and stuff, I'm going to watch it right after I'm drinking, and then I'm going to try to tell you a brief plot summary of what the movie is, like a summarization of the movie. But yeah, so let's get started. And I did get two kinds of beer, but one of them doesn't really count because it's only one pint. But it is what's it called, it's the Speedway Stout by Alesmith, and it is 12%. I don't know if you could see that. And then my go-to beer is just the 805, so I bought a 12 pack of that. And so yeah, let's just get started. It's Valentine's Day, and what better excuse to get drunk on this than make a video, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I know it has been a while since you guys seen my face, and I know you guys miss it. I know you guys always do miss it when I always mention that, and you're probably tired of me saying that every time, but you know what? I'm gonna keep saying it. So, here's the beer number one. Let's do this shit. Fucking hell, boys. All right, so here's the being single, and yeah. All right, guys, so we're back. We just finished watching The Notebook. Wesley came, and you know, I was solo before, but Wesley come over, and then so if I start slurring and stuff, you already know what's going on with me. You know, I've been drinking, Wesley started drinking, and then we're gonna get started with the, you know, the 12% speed ale or speedway stout. So we just finished watching The Notebook. I haven't seen it in a few years, but I do remember some parts. But I'll try to do a little summarization for my, you know, point of view, because obviously, you know, I'm pretty drunk at the time. So obviously, you know, Windows. Wesley. So yeah, so pretty much what the movie is, it's about, you first get started off, you start knowing this character, and it's an old couple. It's about this dude, he starts, you know, reading from like a journal type thing, a notebook, and he starts reading to this female in a retirement home type of situation, and you don't know who they are, you don't know what they have to do with the movie and all. And then he starts, you know, reading these, you know, stories that are written from the journal. And then, so the movie, the way it goes, it goes to flashbacks. So whatever's written in the journal actually is playing on the screen. So,
you know, the two main characters are this guy named Noah.
Yeah.
And the chick named Allie.
Yeah, so those are two main characters, is Noah and Allie. Yeah, in The Notebook. So those are the characters, the main characters of The Notebook, of the guy that's reading. And then later on, you start finding out, like, throughout the movie, that this is going to be spoilers. I don't know if you haven't seen the movie or not.
They should already know.
I mean, you guys probably already know what the movie's about. I mean, if you've seen what this is, but... You know, a lot of people don't know about movies. I mean, like, I haven't seen Saving Private Ryan. I haven't seen I haven't seen Kill Bill.
That's also a good one.
Any of them. You should watch it. What else have I seen? I haven't seen...
see Apocalypse Now until I showed it for you.
Yeah, Wesley...
48 hours
ago. Yeah, dude, Wesley showed me, like, the extended kind of Apocalypse Now, and I barely saw that, like, probably, like, maybe, like, a month or two ago. And, like, I haven't seen that movie. And, I mean, you know, so I haven't seen popular movies that people know about. And I'm pretty sure whoever's watching this, you either know about it or you don't. So it doesn't really matter. But this is just my perspective of it. But, yeah, so Wesley came after work and he's like, what am I doing for Valentine's Day? And I was like, yeah, I'm just getting drunk pretty much. And I have an excuse to make a video to get drunk. And, yeah, so now this is happening. So pretty much, like I said, the movie is about this old couple, you know, that you see, and this old dude, his nickname is the Duke, and everybody knows who he is, and he starts, you know, reading from this journal to this woman, and then you don't know her name till about half of the movie, and he just starts, you know, telling this story pretty much about this couple. And, you know, he starts telling, like, how this couple met, how this couple had their arguments, how they had their, you know, promises. And, like, because the girl, Allie, in The Notebook, she came from a wealthy family. And, yeah, so her parents were about that, like, privilege, like, oh, like, if your boyfriend or whatever isn't rich, then there's no point of, like, you know, dating him in any
there's
reason.
No, like, security.
Yeah, exactly. And then what's Noah's his name? Noah comes from, like, you know, country-like vibe where, you know...
Working class.
Yeah, he's a working class. He works at the lumber yard and, you know...
He's just not rich.
Yeah, he's just not rich. He's just, like... He's getting by, even though he has dinner with Allie's family once, and they ask him, like, oh, how much do you make an hour? And then they're just like, ugh, like, you make that much an hour? There's no point of, like, yeah, like, you're poor. Like, why would Allie even have a interest in you if you're making so little of money? I mean, like, you know.
He's handsome, dude.
Yeah, I mean, like, Ryan Gosling in the movie, fucking, whoo, man, 10 out of 10, 11 out of 10, would not pull out. I mean, like, he is a handsome mofo, even now. But in that movie, you see him as, like, I don't even know when the date is. It looks like 40s, 50s, more like 40s.
About the time era.
I don't know. I don't know what the time era is, but, like, it definitely looks 40s because he goes to the war. I don't know which war. They don't mention it at all. But definitely looks like the 40s, depending on the cars, because they all look like a Fords and pretty much just Fords. They look like a 40s Fords. And Ryan Gosling, whew, definitely would not pull out. But, yeah, for that movie, it's basically about this old couple in the present time, I would guess. I mean, I would assume it's more of, like, early 2000s, 90s, maybe early 2000s, where this old couple, especially the dude, the Duke, is retelling the story from a journal to a lady that you do not know the name of until pretty much the middle of the movie. And then you start finding out that in the middle of the movie... the girl's name is Allie, and then you start piecing stuff together where you're like, oh, snaps, like,
She's the same Allie from the book.
Yeah, she's the Allie from the book. And then you start realizing, like, oh, snap, like, that old guy, the Duke, that you start realizing he's actually Noah from the book. So, and then, like, they start giving you small hints where she has Alzheimer's or something like that. Like, maybe some sort of disease. I don't know if it's Alzheimer's for sure, that it's, or dementia or whatever.
Probably dementia.
Yeah, I don't know. Like one of those decisions where she doesn't really remember her past. And then so he reads to her every single day of, you know, whatever is happening. So every single day he starts reading from this notebook because it's essentially their journal that they're, you know, they wrote together as a couple. And then later on in the movie, you start realizing that, you know, it is them. It's Noah and Allie. And then towards the end of the movie, you actually see Allie's signature saying, like, yo, well, not yo, but, like, she says, read this to me, and then eventually I'll come back to you. And, like, not gonna lie, because I was alone during when I started the first portion of this recording. And then Wesley was like, I'm going to come over. And I was like, yeah, sure. I teared up, cried a little bit. Not going to lie. It's a really good movie. I mean, I don't know how you felt towards it, but damn, dude. Like, this movie is good. Not even if you're, like, into romantic, I guess. Like, it has some comedic features, but it's more of, like, a romantic story type of thing that's going on. But I mean, shit. If you haven't seen this movie, I don't know what you're doing, because it's really popular, especially during Valentine's Day. I feel like it's one of the Valentine's Day movies that you should watch. That's why I chose it, because I feel like it's so popular that, like, a lot of people know it, even if they haven't seen it. Like, they've heard about it from a friend or two. Yeah, it's definitely mentioned. And then, but yeah, I mean, like, The Notebook is a great series. Not even a series, it's just one movie. But, like, I feel like you should watch it even if you haven't, because it's such a great storyline. The way it's told, the way the scenes are portrayed and stuff like that, it's, like, definitely a great movie. I mean, like, even if, especially on Valentine's Day, if you're watching that with your girlfriend or boyfriend or whatever's going on, it's a great movie just to be like, wow, I cherish the person that I'm actually in love with. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's perspective.
Yeah. Because a lot of people, like, you know, it's like puppy love and stuff like that. But, like, if you're actually in love with somebody, you would be with them, you know, not for their money, not for, you know, what they do as a job, and not, like, judge them. It's like, I feel this way, they make me, you know, feel a certain way than somebody else would. And it's like, it's such a great movie. And just, like, Ryan Gosling is a bae, dude. That's just a plus. I mean, like, honestly, that's a plus. I mean, it's a great movie. And, but yeah, like I said, pretty much the plot is just about this old couple that you see in the beginning of the movie. You don't know who they are, what they have to do with the movie. And then you start realizing that whatever story the Duke is telling is actually Noah, which is the person in the notebook that, you know, he's trying to get his, you know, his wife or his girlfriend. I don't know if they married. They didn't say anything about it. They're probably married, but they
have kids and everything.
Yeah, they have kids.
That time, like, it's expected of them.
Yeah. So, yeah, so, like Wesley said, like, expected, they're supposed to be married and stuff like that, and they have kids. They have, like, a whole bunch of kids. And, yeah, so it's just crazy to see, like, this, like, person with Alzheimer's or dementia or whatever is, like, they don't know who their husband is and stuff like that, but he tries every, like, single day.
Like, you live your whole life with this person.
Yeah.
Just for them to forget.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like, even there's a scene in the movie where her kids or their kids come to you know, to visit them at the retirement home or this mental hospital that they're at. And it's like, the, you know, Duke or Noah essentially doesn't really have to be there, but he's there because he says, like, you know, pretty much, like, this is the love of my life. I'm going to keep living here as much as I want to because I want to have her remember who I am and who you guys are. Because he has, like, I don't know, like, 5 kids. I don't remember exactly, but around there, he has, like, 5 children, or they have 5 children, and she does not remember a single one of them, and it's, like, really heartbreaking. And the thing is, like, that happens in the real life. But the crazy thing is that that happens in the real life. I mean, like, so this movie pretty much captures that that actually happens in the real life. I mean, I've seen some videos. I saw this one recently where this guy, he takes his mother out. I think it was Denny's or something. He takes her out to Denny's, and then, what's it called? They're just sitting across from each other, and then he's all like, oh, do you remember who I am? And she's like, not really, kinda. And then he's like, well, do you remember this name? I forgot his name. But he's like, do you remember this name? And she's like, oh, it kind of rings a bell. And then afterwards, you know, he's in his car, and then he starts saying, like, I can't believe, like, my own mother didn't recognize who I was. And, like, you know, it's his own mother. So that it's, like, pretty crazy because, like, that actually happens. I mean, this story could be based on a true story, or, like, somebody can be going through this right now, whether you be a son, daughter, or, like, husband or wife or something like that, which is pretty crazy. And it's, like, that's kind of, like, the scary thing about being older. It's, like, you know, how would you say, like, a senior, I guess? And that's the crazy thing to, like, think about as a senior is that, like, right now when you're young, you're in your 20s. Yeah, you don't really think about that stuff. You're just enjoying your time, whoever you're with, or exploring, experiencing your life decisions, you know, whether you want to be traveling, whether you want to be, you know, going out or stuff like that. It's like you don't really think about the future. And then, like, once it starts happening where it goes to dementia and stuff like that, it's like, it's just crazy, man. Like, so
you're not in control anymore.
Yeah, you're not in control. And that's, like, true. And it's like, I mean, you could, as hard as you can, whoever your opposite other is, and they're trying to help you on what they want to do with you and stuff like that, and, like, if they actually have the, like, they want to try to make you remember, it's like, damn, dude, like, yeah.
Well,
that's a scary thing.
Like, one thing in the movie, like, they don't say it outright, but you witness it, like, okay, like, she has to, she can't remember anything, and he reads to her every single day, like, this
yeah.
is, like, the movie that you see is what they do every single day.
Yeah.
So it's like, they don't say how long she's been like that. They don't say, like, oh, it's been like 3 years or like 12 years or whatever that she can't remember. So you have the idea in your head that, like, oh shit, he's been doing this every single day for, like, you don't even know how long.
Yeah, exactly.
And so the point is, like, in the movie that they want to stress is, like, he loves her that much that he would do that, like,
yeah.
even if she doesn't remember him.
And he doesn't have to live there. Even his kids, his children say, like, you know, why don't you come live with us or live on your own? Because, like, we miss you. Like, you know, you're our father. Like, you literally don't have to be here because our mom won't remember us regardless. And then he pretty much says, like, I'm going to do this because I love her. The person that I love the most is here, you know, like,
pretty much they told him, you can move on.
Yeah, exactly.
We're not gonna, like, hate you or feel bad if you decide, like, you know what, yeah, I want to live by myself or, like, live closer to you guys. So he's like, no, this is what I wanted. I want to be with her for the rest of my life, and this is the rest of my life.
Yeah. That's basically what it said. He's like, the rest of my life, I'm going to be here until I could get her to remember. And if not, then I'm just going to keep trying every single day. And it's just like, I mean, like, that's such great writing, and that's such a good movie. I mean,
that's
like,
gnarly too. Like,
yeah.
When you think about that shit, like, oh, fuck, dude.
Because that starts making you think that, like, I mean, right now, you guys, whoever watching this, you might not think, like, right now it's all like, oh, I'm not going to really, you know, bust my ass saying, like, oh, I'm going to be, you know, helping whoever that loves me or whatever. But once you start, like, realizing that, like, this is the person you love and stuff like that, and, like, you would do anything, literally anything, to make them remember or, you know, revisit those memories that you guys had together, it's just, like, it's just crazy. I mean, like, I'm pretty sure it happens, but you don't really hear about it in the news or anything like that, because who would be interested in some random person saying, like, oh, like, this person, this couple, they've had the Alzheimer's, and then they got back together, or she remembered for a few minutes, you know? I mean, that's not, I mean, it is amazingly heartwarming, but a lot of people more are, like, interested in memes and, like, the war that's going on. Or that
politics.
No. Yeah, politics or some bullshit like that. And it's like, so this, I'm pretty sure this happens on a regular basis, but it's just not really heard about because it's not so popular. But it's just, like, it's crazy that it happens, because, like, if you were put into that position, it's just astounding. I mean, like, if my mom ever went through that and then she didn't know I was her son, like, that's crazy, man.
Yeah.
Like, somebody you knew your whole life, and then, yeah, just forgets you and says, like, who are you? Like, I don't even know who you are. And then you're trying to be like, do you remember this? Like, you don't remember this happening, or, like, you know, my birthday or anything like this. It's like,
yeah. And if you show them photos too, they get confused. They're like, when did this happen? Or, like, they, it's out of their comprehension.
Yeah. And it's, like, crazy, because, like, sometimes that you see people, like the video that I mentioned earlier, it's like, this dude was telling him, like, oh, you don't remember, like, do you know who you're talking to now? And she's like, no, but, like, I kind of have, like, an idea who you are. And he's just saying, like, do you remember this? Do you remember that? Like, you know, stuff like that. And then she's just like, I don't know who you are. And then, you know, after he drops her off, I'm pretty sure it's a retirement home or something, he's like, it's kind of sad and, like, hurtful. He starts crying and he's like, it's kind of hurtful that, like, you know, your own mom doesn't know who you are. And it's just like, that's crazy. It's like one of the, like, small bitter facts of life that happens to, like,
it's a possibility.
It's a possibility that that can happen. So, I mean, what other movie than Valentine's Day to do this is, like, I mean, it doesn't have to necessarily be whoever, like, you cherish and love on Valentine's Day do something extra special on this day, when reality you should be doing something every day so they know that they feel special. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Maybe it should be another video, but
no. Yeah, it should be another video, but, like, I'm just saying, like, you know, like, whoever you love, whoever you care about, you should be treating that way every single day. Yeah.
Not just on one particular
day. Yeah, like, if it's Father's Day, if it's Mother's Day, if it's Valentine's Day, if it's Christmas, New Year's, or a birthday, you should be treating them that way every single day. You don't have to have, like, a scheduled, you know, event.
Be spontaneous.
Yeah, be spontaneous. I mean, like, even if it's a one random day, be like, you know, I got you a flower because, you know, I care about you. You know, just show something.
Doesn't have to be like $1 million diamond. Yeah. Or like a boat or something. No, but just.
It doesn't even have to be a flower. It could just be food and be like, oh, you know, you told me that you like this type of food and, you know, I decided to bring it. Maybe we could eat it together or something.
You made your own card or exactly. Wrote notes or a letter.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be something extravagant. Just a random.
Just let know. Whoever you're caring about knows that they feel cared about, you know, appreciated. So, because you never know what could happen. You never know. But, yeah. So, this has pretty much been the Valentine's special. And it's, like, it's been really sad. But, you know, it's the true life. So, I'll see you guys in the next video.